I'm ready for this challenge.
She's thick, she's bad, so clean, she's fine, she loves, she hates, she laughs, she cries, she hurts, she lies, she's ghetto, she's real, she sings, she rhymes, she comes, she goes, she lives, she dies, she's sexy and bomb, she blows my mind.
National team hitting the field in Portland, Oregon. One more stop before the final next week in Los Angeles. Look at the brackets. USA and Germany advancing in the upper portion of the bracket. They will meet in just a few minutes' time in the other matchup, Sweden versus Canada. The winners of those two will go on and play in the final next week in L.A. And a pleasant good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Portland, Oregon. I'm J.P. Della Camera. When this tournament first began, we talked about the young talent on the U.S. squad, and Wendy Guevara-Palladino, one of those stars that's risen to the challenge, is Abby Wambach.
She sure has, J.P. It's amazing, really. All the press is focusing on Abby Wambach. Some people are saying that she has made the most impact of any player in this entire event. Now, we know that she's a workhorse up top on defense, and she really doesn't get a lot of credit for that. But how is Germany going to stop her in the air? This game is setting up for Mia Hamm to have a breakout event because there's no pressure on her.
As for the Germans, they have plenty of personality players on their own as well. And Tony DiCicco, if Germany is to be successful today, you would have to think Prinz and Meinert would have to play well.
Well, Germany has scored 20 goals in this tournament. They have a lot of talented players, but Maren Meinert and Birgit Prinz are two of the best. Meinert can score goals, but she can also find anyone with final passes. And Birgit Prinz in front of goal is devastating. The U.S. defense is going to be tested tonight.
Prinz is the leading goal scorer right now in this tournament. Meinert leading the tournament in assists, tying a Mia Hamm record from the 1995 World Cup. The number one offense of Germany versus the USA's number one defense. Come back with us.
Is it or is it not true that you kicked and pummeled the plaintiff in the plain view of over 60,000 witnesses?
It's true.
And what did you and your malicious co-conspirators do next?
We cheered.
As this poor, battered soul lay defenseless and deflated. You didn't tell me you cheered.
Bud Light, proud sponsor of the U.S. Women's National Team in the FIFA Women's World Cup.
We're toast.
Years of photography experience. Legendary optics. Canon PowerShot digital cameras. Now with the Digic chip for beautiful photographs that happen to be digital. Digital revolutionized photography. We revolutionized digital.
Side of it for me,
because so much of what I do is trust. People are really apprehensive about dealing with an insurance company. They get on the phone and you can hear just kind of that fatigue in their voice, and you tell them, I'm going to be sending a check. You hear that lift in their voice, and it makes you feel like you've done something that day that's really important. I'm Unum Provident, and my co-workers are Unum Provident. We're the company, and we care about what we do.
Rock and roll legend Roger Daltrey on the History Channel.
I never knew history could be this hard.
The History Channel presents Extreme History, hosted by Roger Daltrey. Come along with Roger as he relives some of history's epic adventures under the most primitive conditions.
Have you ever eaten beaver?
Extreme History, hosted by Roger Daltrey.
Watch the bloody show.
Premieres tonight at 9:30, only on the History Channel.
Where the friggin' past comes alive.
In Roger's case, a little too alive.
ESPN2's coverage of the 2003 FIFA Women's World Cup is brought to you by Bud Light, official beer of the U.S. Women's National Soccer Team. Toshiba, proud to be supporting the FIFA Women's World Cup as official IT partner. Adidas, proud sponsor of FIFA Women's World Cup 2003. Own the ball and you own the game. Hyundai, when your car comes with America's best warranty, you win. Hyundai. And by Time Warner Cable. Now, anything's possible.
Welcome back. Everyone, Germany getting ready to take on the United States minus Brandi Chastain for the fourth consecutive game. Yet, all in all, the U.S. defense has only allowed one goal in this tournament. More on the USA's defense downstairs to Tisha Hope.
Since Brandi Chastain went down in the first game, Joy Fawcett has really stepped up and taken a leadership role for this U.S. team. Although the U.S. back line has been extremely strong, Joy credits total team defense. She says, when the forwards and midfielders are playing good, organized defense, it makes the life for the back line a heck of a lot easier. They're going to need that team defense today against this dangerous German attack. Up to you, JP.
Thanks, Tish. USA versus Germany for the right to go on to the final next weekend versus the winner of Canada-Sweden. And that'll be the second game we'll have for you coming up later today here on ESPN2. The USA will be in red and white, Germany in white and black. USA starting lineup, Wendy, brought to you by Adidas with Story and Gold.
And the U.S. will play a 4-3-3 like we saw them play against Sweden. They're going to play high pressure all over the field in the defense. We see the outside backs are going to have a huge responsibility. Reddick and Bivens are going to have to shift and rotate on ball side to get into the outside midfield position. Bivens gets a start because she does that very naturally. In the midfield, the key is box. In that space that she's holding in the midfield, that's where Germany is going to try and set their play, namely through Maren Meinert. Box is going to have to shut that down. And up top, a three front, like I said, they're going to high pressure just like they did against Sweden. How do you stop Parlow and Wambach in the air, and how do you stop Mia Hamm's explosion?
This is Wambach on the left side, got around one defender. Cannot get around a second one. It's cleared away by Ariana Hinks, but Wambach will be a handful today for Germany to watch. Throw in for Christine Lilly. Wambach will touch it back. Lilly with a left-footed cross. And Germany just cleared it out. There wasn't that much pressure there. A little panic perhaps from Gottschalk to clear it out for an unnecessary corner, where Wendy, the USA has been very dangerous on these set pieces.
Well, they absolutely have. The U.S.'s success on set pieces is unprecedented. And Wambach and Parlow, great in the air on these set pieces.
One of the keys, Ken. Germany stopped the set pieces of the United States.
Hamm will play it across. Box was up, not it down. And Fawcett was up there as well. Kat Reddick also made a run. It'll be the second corner kick coming up for the USA. This one from the opposite side. Fawcett very good in the air and causing some havoc in front.
JP, also the sun is really in the eyes of these Germans. This goalkeeper here, Rottenberg, she's looking right at the sun trying to make a save.
Hamm is ready for another corner in the third minute. She'll drive it across, going near side. That one somehow stayed in play. Kick off stigma. There's no whistle. And finally, throughout Germany can't clear. That ball was out, I think, initially, but there was no whistle. The goal kick coming up for Rottenberg. Germany starting lineup brought to you by Hyundai, and it starts with the experienced Rottenberg in goal.
Well, she's going to be tested today. The U.S. will be sending a lot of forwards into their attacking zone. In the defense, Hinks and Minert in the middle of the defense have got to stop the U.S. attack. And in the midfield, watch Bettina Wiegmann. She has always played well against the USA. She's a key player for them. And then, of course, up front, you've got the dynamic duel of Maren Meinert and Birgit Prinz. The U.S. is going to have to deal with their scoring punch.
Hinks will try the long ball on the right side. Kat Reddick is back, and it's going to be knocked out of play. We'd like to thank Adidas and all of our sponsors for allowing us to bring you this FIFA Women's World Cup match without interruption. Intended for Meinert. That's going to be cleared away. USA will want to deny Meinert the ball as best they can, and when she has it, make sure there's a player or two on her. Sobrero blocked. This is Birgit Prinz going to the outside, and Garofrekas lost it. It's a goal kick.
JP, I want to point out in the lineups, we actually had Reddick on the left side, but Kate Sobrero is pushing out into that left back position, and Reddick is in the center with Joy Fawcett.
What we're also seeing here is a little bit un-German-like, some longer balls, and you may see some of that. They've got some talented players up front. If they can win some balls facing the U.S. goal, they'll be dangerous with their final passes.
Along the far sideline, That is Kylie Bivens getting another start in this World Cup. On a play it goes, another throw in for the USA in the fifth minute of play. Scoreless here as the USA attacks in the red and white. Foudy leaves it off. Ball is played across too slowly, and Germany will clear it up. They find the feet of Meinert, and then it's passed away. They had some pressure on Meinert that time, which forced a bad pass. Off that throw-in. Parlos on the right, putting on some pressure, but that ball, apparently the entire ball, is out. April Heinrichs looking on. Tremendous winning record as the head coach of this USA squad. Finished runner-up in the last Olympics. Trying to add a World Cup title to that resume. Over the shoulder comes Reddick. Germany had some pressure on her. By the halfway line it comes. USA with an early ball towards Wambach. Rottenberg was out of the box. She had to win that one there. Flag is up on the opposite side from the referee's assistant.
Two key players in this match. Shannon Box, the holding midfielder for the USA, and Lingor, the holding midfielder for Germany. They're going to have huge responsibilities, not only in possession, but in helping with the defense.
Meinert on the quick turnover, and here she comes. Her Boston Breaker teammate Sobrero trailed, and Meinert forced that pass intended for Prinz. Flag was up anyway on Germany.
Just to continue on Tony's point, one of the ways that those players are going to help on team defense is by winning the second ball. So first ball is a 50-50 ball. It's not possessed. And Box and Lingor as well will try and settle the ball down a little bit and get it under control.
Scurry slipped as she booted that ball up near the halfway line. And will take it over. And that one was knocked away by Stegman. Another USA throw-in. Near side for Sobrero. Lilly kept that ball in play. Now it's knocked out by Birgit Prinz. Another USA throw-in. Prinz has had a couple of good WSA seasons, and playing in the WSA has certainly helped elevate her game, which was strong to begin with. Headed for Wambach. Broken up. Cleared up. How quickly the Germans move it upfield to Meinert, but that last pass was deflected off Foudy and played back to Ryan Ascurry.
Actually, Maren Meinert has had three opportunities to make very dangerous passes. She hasn't connected with any yet. That's very uncharacteristic for her. She might be a little bit nervous right now in this game.
Ham saw the keeper out, and that was not a bad idea. But Rottenberg was able to get back into position. That'll be a goal kick coming up.
I can't emphasize enough how much this sun is going to be a problem for Rottenberg if the U.S. can get some shots on the face of the goal.
Tony, we should say something about the German starting lineup. We had thought Meinert would be playing behind two strikers, but they've changed their lineup, which indicated to you more of a defensive alignment than offensive.
Yeah, and the way I look at it is they blinked. They blinked a little bit. Müller, who's a great scoring presence up front, they traded a defensive personality for her scoring punch. It's a little bit of a blink. Let's see if it works for Coach Tina Toynmeyer.
Especially, Tony, when you look and see that Germany scored 20 goals, they've gotten this far with offense, and yet they came in today with not what you would think is their totally best offensive lineup. Carlo trying to clear this ball upfield, and it goes out off a deflection. Throw-in coming up. USA versus Germany. Winner goes on to the winner of the Canada-Sweden match for the final next week in L.A. We'll have that second game coming up for you on ESPN2 later. Stegman. Gera Freckes clearing it. Reddick will clear it. Reddick's become a regular since the Chastain injury. There's Box. Another regular since this World Cup began. It's deflected all the way back towards Brian Ascurry, who'll have to be active today in possible German counterattacks.
One of the reasons for that is that this U.S. defense, when they're playing a 4-3-3, they're trying to high pressure, which also means that their back line will push up. They'll try and compress the space that Germany is trying to play out of. So if a ball's over the top, that's when Brian Ascurry has to come out very aggressively and make the play if her defenders are getting beat.
I think both teams are playing a little bit nervous right now, which is understandable. These are the two teams that I think have been pressed most in the World Cup. Neither have started to get their rhythm in passing. Let's see which one does get it first.
Gera Freckes, nice cross, but Scurry's right there. Brianna coming up with it. They were looking for Prinz on that, as they generally do on crosses from either side. She's their best target player.
Now that's a big play for Brianna Scurry to start off, go out there and win that cross. I mean, you know, goalkeepers want to get their hands on the ball early. They want to make a good play. That's a good start for her.
Off that free kick. Coming back towards Wambach. Germany have two defenders back. Wambach carries, finds Lily. The ball took a while to get there, though. Lily pokes it ahead, but couldn't reach it on her own. And it'll go right back to Rottenberg. Christine Lily playing in her fourth World Cup, very steady, always dependable, especially in the bigger games. Rottenberg clearance long. Bivens missed that one. Prinz goes after, but Fawcett is there to send it out. 10 minutes gone. Throw in for Germany from the far side. Finder slipped that pass up to Lingor. Down by Kat Reddick. Picked up by Kylie Bivens. Bivens will clear it up the wing. And a couple of awkward touches early for Kylie Bivens starting on that right side.
Seen a lot of awkward touches by a lot of pretty experienced players, so it's just not Kylie.
Meinert for Garofrekas. Second quality cross, but it's deflected away. Germany will put it back with Meinert. And then Sobrero with a clearance. Knotted down, and then Parlo. Sent back by Gottschalk. And Wunderlich was there. It goes out. The USA will have it. But Germany has spent some time in the USA's end early. Coming back, nice ball, Lily on the left foot, and then lost it. That first touch failed. Parlo back. Foudy advancing. Plays it to the corner. The flag went up on Parlo. Offside.
The U.S. is trying to get into the attack here, and Parlo makes that run down the right flank, and as the ball is served, she's just behind her defender, gets called offside.
Yeah, but she was onsides on that one, Wendy. I think that the referee has to make sure that it's offside before they raise the flag. I think that was a good timed run, unfortunately, for the U.S. It's going to go their way.
The Germany free kick intended for Prinz. Foudy with it. Hamp running at Gottschalk. And Gottschalk gets the better. Germany will send it across the way. Stegman. Wrong side of Meinert. And then Stegman took advantage of a giveaway from Box. Long clearance the other way. Bivens trying to track it down. Prinz is right there. Good second effort from Kylie Bivens, staying with the much bigger Birgit Prinz.
Both these teams are great at going from defense to offense. I think Germany's a little bit suspect going from offense to defense, and we might see the USA get an opportunity too.
Tony, that's a great point to make this early in the match, because number two Stegman, who we just saw serve that very long ball for Germany to try and spring an attack, is the player who tends to really wander forward. The question is, will she get back into the correct formation and correct space in order to defend if the U.S. gets a quick counterattack?
That one goes off Cindy Parlow and out. Throw-in coming up. One more team will be making the final tonight besides the winner of this one. Semifinal number two is coming up. Sweden versus Canada live at 10:25 here on ESPN2. How about Canada? Tony, they knocked China right out of the tournament.
Well, we're not sure China ever really showed up for the tournament, but don't take anything away from the Canadians. They are a good team, and no one wants to play them with the combative style that they bring to the game.
They're calling it, Wendy, the biggest victory in the history of the Canadian women's national team program.
Of course, their head coach, Evan Pellerud, spent years with Norway, even won a world championship coaching Norway, so he knows the Swedes very well. Should be pretty interesting to see how he gets his team ready.
14th minute here. Still looking at a scoreless one. Germany and the United States. Carlo has it toe poked away. Foudy stays with it. Back for Bivens. To Foudy. Trying to pushing it up for Bivens to find some space. And intended for Ham, who had left that space. It comes back. Fawcett up with Bivens. This is as far up as Joy Fawcett has come during the run of play. She's trying to scramble back now. You've got a piece of the ball. Birgit Prinz, and Fawcett got a piece of her.
Joy Fawcett's starting positions defensively are just flawless, and that's why she's able to just nip in. You never see Joy in a collision. She just kind of picks your pocket and picks the attacking player's pocket and takes the ball away.
Wunderlich is wide, and off Fawcett it'll go for Germany's first corner kick of the match. And Tony, what do we look for here on Germany? corners and set pieces.
Well, they're going to use variations. They're going to flight some in, but they know that Bryant's going to dominate if they put too much fluff on these balls. So they're going to use some variation. They've got some big players. Garofrakis can get up and head the ball. Of course, Prince is dangerous, and even Gottlieb.
Played across. Garofrakis with a head off the crossbar in. Garofrakis has scored the goal. Germany has the lead over the United States. The first time the USA has trailed in this World Cup.
Look at the driven cross in here. Garofrakis gets yourself in a perfect position. It's almost impossible for the goalkeeper to stop that because it's in the back of the net before he can even react to it. That is a great driven ball, a great flicked on ball, and off the crossbar and in. You got to give Germany credit for that outstanding goal.
Talked all along about this tournament, about the set pieces and the accuracy and the success, Wendy, of the USA. That was a German corner kick at its precision best.
Absolutely perfectly executed with the near post run and a great finish just on a flick. All Garofrakis did was kept it going in the direction of the goal, and I felt from watching from up here that the U.S. defense didn't follow her well enough. She actually had two players kind of in the vicinity, Foudy and Wambach, but nobody actually went up and gave her a good challenge on that header.
That's a good point, Wendy. With a player like that, who's a target player with her size, you need to have somebody fronting her as well as behind her. She makes a good run. Somebody's got to have a position in front of her.
Fourth goal in World Cup play. That's been a bit of a surprise for Germany. Real move out the other good goal scorers. And we'll go on to play. And now we see, Tony, how the USA reacts down a goal. This hasn't happened to them in this tournament.
Well, you're right. And, you know, talking to Coach Tina Toynmeyer yesterday, and I said, how are you going to deal with the American set pieces? And her answer was, we have good set pieces also. And she proved us right there.
USA down by a goal early here as well. Players pushing forward. This is where they scored a goal the other night. Redick found Wambach in the box on a free kick from distance. This one is up there. Harlow headed it toward goal. Looked like it was more of a pass, a flick on the Wambach, but it was closer to Rottenberg, the goalkeeper. And the toss is wide to the left side, and we'll see how, we'll talk about how the USA comes back. How does Germany now play with this lead? And it's for Prinz, and that goes out of play.
Tony, does this remind you a little bit of 99? Game against Germany?
Now that you've brought it up, Wendy, yeah, I think we went down early in that game. And remember, the USA brings a mentality that very few teams can match in the world. We've always thought that Norway also has that mentality. One of the questions that I had before this game, is Germany going to be able to match the USA mentality? At this point of the game, I'd say yes, they have been able to match it. But it's a long game, it's a 90-minute game, and you know the U.S. are going to be fighting for every minute throughout the game.
The game that Wendy brought up, Germany led in that game twice, including once at halftime. It was the quarterfinals of that World Cup, and most people felt that was the best game played between two teams in that cup. Harlow is tripped. Nope. Sonja Denoncourt says no. Foudy's pass to Bivens, pushing up. Bivens trying to take it deep, that's knocked out, and obviously somebody has to cover for her. There was a lot of space behind Kylie Bivens had Germany won that ball.
One of the ways that the U.S. defense does cover is they just have to shift across. They can't find themselves too spread out, however.
Now, there's a rotation that goes on, so as Kylie Bivens goes up on the strong side, Joy Foster would slide over, Kat Reddick will slide over, and then, of course, Kate Sobrero slides over. So the only space is about 70 yards away where there's some open space.
Settled by Lily. And the left-footed shot went wide of the target. Let's have a flashback. Back to 99, Germany and the USA. Bettina Wiegmann, nice strike right before the half ended 2-1. Then Chastain tied it at 2. And then the game-winning goal, Shannon McMillan finds Joy Fawcett. 3-2, USA 1. Then they played Brazil in the semifinals and then went on to defeat China on penalty kicks in the World Cup final. Picked off by Box. Nice bit of dribbling. Shannon Box carries. Puts it through. Wambach on the right. Inside the 18. A cutting ball back was deflected. And then just safely cleared out by Linger. Throw in for the USA.
Key play by Shannon Box. That's when that graphic of the German defense not being able to transition back quick enough.
A Wambach to throw, and it's Fouty. Off one deflection. Wambach couldn't get it. Ham couldn't get to that ball either. Settled by Reddick. Open up there. Gathered in by Ham. Mueller's pass didn't get to Wong, but it may get to Lilly. It's intended for Wambach, and Rottenberg doesn't want to take any chances. Corner kick, USA their third.
Let me tell you, that's bad goalkeeping in my book. Get down on the ground, win that ball. Do not give up a set piece to the United States with their record.
Lilly's going to take this one. A left footer that comes out. Wambach couldn't get that in the air. Box can. Towards Meinert, who won that ball. And now Germany attacks. Three on three. A nice ball in his face. And then an early ball from Meinert. That was on target. And Germany might have had a chance with Gottschalk coming way up.
Well, you see the German counterattack right there. And again, Meinert's final pass isn't there yet. But she's dangerous.
On the far side, Carlo. Good work rate. She'll win it. Plays it across in front of Wambach. Ham was also there. Cleared by Wigman. Germany are clearing a lot of balls out. Very cautious. They're up 1-0.
You know, Cindy Parlow's known for her abilities in the air, but look how she plays, wins this ball here, and then dink, touches it away, finds herself some time to get a nice pass into the seam.
It's a live action. Box will play it back into the middle. Reddick will send it up. Too far for Ham. Gara Frekas, who has scored the game's only goal, will take it and face the goal. Pass over to Wigman. The side flag went up. Wigman, the captain of Germany, playing in her fourth World Cup, and she was the first one to score in all four World Cups.
Here's Gara Frekas, and what I like is that she gets into the center of the field, but clearly Wigman is just a step offside as the ball is delivered.
Up for Wambach. Right side, Carlo, tough angle. Plays it across, and there was Rottenberg. 22nd minute. USA trailing for the first time in this World Cup against Germany, who's had an easy road to this point to get to the semifinals. Knocked out by the USA.
Wendy, I'm starting to see some breaks into the German defense here. There's some breakdowns. There's some good numbers of U.S. players running into the penalty area. Maybe a better service there by Parlo could have ended up with a shot on goal.
Absolutely. I mean, they're finding themselves with some good chances, like you said, Tony. And one of the reasons is Germany is just not getting their players back with good organization quick enough, and the U.S. is getting sprung on some quick counterattacks.
April Heinrichs on the sideline, 23rd minute. Respects the Germans. Talked a lot about Germany and the kind of game they would bring to the table here today. On the right side, here is Parlo. Looking across in the flag. Tough to get on that far side. Rottenberg will toss it up. Germany will try to switch it to Gara Frekas. What a collision there with Sobrero. Up for Box. Was tackled off the ball, picked up by Wigman. Played the first 2 years in the WSA with Boston as a teammate of Meinert's. This time Sobrero, her breaker teammate, breaks it up. Out it goes for a throw-in for Germany. Gara Frekas quickly there. Meinert to Gara Frekas, right at the byline, and corner kick. So Germany will have another one from this side of the field, their second one.
Not a popular call, but it was the right call.
Very making sure everybody picks up a player.
Now watch Minnert on the back post. They've attacked the front post with Gara Frekas. Watch Minnert on the back post.
That's a different look, but it went away from Lingard. Not a bad idea, but a terrible ball. Here is Box running it back. She goes down, and the ball is controlled by Germany.
Wendy, those are the balls you hope that Mia Hamm picks up and starts running at the other defense.
Absolutely. Box is not going to be able to do that all game long. I would like to critique her at this point and just say, you know, she's doing a good job getting plugged into the flow of the game, but she's holding the ball too much in that midfield. Even then, she didn't have players running with her. Wambach was close in support, but not up there. Just go ahead and pull it back and let your team regroup. She's not going to be the player that's going to spring a counterattack with the dribble herself.
Bivens, and that ball goes out of play. USA playing without Brandi Chastain, but she's there supporting the team. For more on the veteran Brandi Chastain, downstairs to Tisha Hope.
Brandi Chastain, the only member of the U.S. squad still standing on the bench. I just heard her yell out, keep attacking, keep going at them, we're breaking them down. And she's right, I think we've seen some chances here. I think we just need to see a better final pass and the U.S. will be right back in this game.
She's standing on that broken right foot. Had some discomfort yesterday, and still it's considered day-to-day. The USA is not saying anything more about Brandi Chastain's condition. But, Tony, they miss her out on the field, but she's doing her part on the bench.
She's a great leader, and you can imagine how difficult this is for her. But she continues to help the team, and you can only respect her for that.
Germany coming back. Up for Wiegmann. Wiegmann will turn. And send it the other way.
That's a great ball. That is just a great ball.
Girafrekas tackled out by Sobrero. The highest scoring team in this World Cup has the only goal. That's Germany. Meinert went down. No call there either. Ham got a step behind the defense. Hinkst. This is Mia. Inside the 18. Looking. Trying to square it. But that pass was given away to Germany. Wambach fighting for it. Stegman will clear. Intercepted. Box slipping as she made that pass. A deflection. Lilly wants the left foot. The shot. Nice save, Rodenberg. When Lilly goes to the left foot like that, you anticipate at least a good scoring chance.
Lilly loves to be in this position on the field where she's at the diamond at the front of this central midfield position. Look at her unleash that shot there, and Rottenberg makes a nice extension to make the save.
Now that's more like goalkeeping, you know, get down and get dirty, get after that ball. That's a good save. Also a very, very good shot by Christine Lilly. And you know, Wendy, what you said about Shannon Box, she is starting to release the ball earlier now, and I think that is adding to the USA attack.
Guys, 26th minute, that's the first USA shot on goal. That's unusual in this tournament. Usually it's the other team you're talking about that doesn't have any shots.
Well, shots on goal is one thing, but they've had a lot of dangerous opportunities. I think Cindy Parlow's been getting a lot of play on the right side of the, on her right side and the left side of the German defense, and Germany's going to have to make adjustments there.
Girafrekas. That one's blocked. Taken away by the U.S. Sobrero. Germany winning that ball as well. Wiegmann off a block. Stegman is back. What a collision there with Wambach. United player giving on that challenge. Lingert intercepted by the U.S. It'll be played to Lilly. She'll try to bring it back. A lot of things happening in the field that are being let go here. Box going in hard to tackle. And finally, Girafrekas will play it over. Scurry's coming way out. Able to get there before Prinz or Kat Reddick. She was ready for it.
That's a big play by Bryce Scurry, because let me tell you something. You can see that Prinz is faster than Reddick and had a step on her.
Not only that, Tony, she's faster as she takes her third step, fourth step, fifth step. She gets quicker, and that's where Brianna Scurry made that save, as just as Prinz was picking up on her speed.
Off a deflection. Finally, Bivens will pick it up and play it right to Julie Foudy. Foudy with a look up for Wambach. And that one's broken up by Germany. They lose it there. Parlo toe poking it. Ham makes a run. The shot's blocked. Picked up on the far side, and Germany will just boot it out. Again, playing very cautious once they've won a ball like that. Minute cleared. A Ham teammate with a Washington Freedom. In. Wambach nods it down. The captain, Julie Foudy, looks for Ham. And Rottenberg will let that one go out. It'll be a goal kick coming up.
Gottschalk in the left back for the Germans is struggling a bit. There's a lot of play coming off her side. That was a great run by Mia, but it's set up by Cindy Parlow finding space and having the opportunity to slide that diagonal ball to Mia as she's sprinting into the penalty area.
I really like what we've seen out of Parlow so far in this match. She is doing a good job to play make, and I would say, like Tish said down on the sidelines in her comment, the U.S. just needs to brush up on their final pass, and that's where Parlow's been a bit weak a couple times.
Here she comes. Parlow with it inside the 18. Pokes it to the byline and maybe a tad too far, but she's going to get a corner kick out of it. minute protesting, but apparently she knocked it out. At least that's what the referee's assistant is saying on the far side.
If I'm Tina Toyne-Meyer right now, I'm trying to look down my bench and saying, who can I use to stop Cindy Parlo?
Look at her just working some magic here on this German defense. They really don't have a lot of answers for her, and in this scenario, I think she just held on to it a little bit too long. She let one too many German defenders get over there.
Off that corner. Wambach came flashing out after it. Christine Lilly got a piece of the ball. Birgit Prinz is back for it. Pulled down by Parlo, and the foul wasn't going to be called originally, but then I think when Prinz went down and Parlo ended up with the ball, it has to be called.
Here's the takedown here. Parlo has her hand there on Birgit Prinz's right shoulder, and that's really, as forwards, we're taught how to fall. If you've got a little bit of pressure on that far shoulder, just continue with the spin. So that really wasn't a foul, but Prinz played it well to get the possession back.
Wait a minute. Forwards are taught to fall?
We call that sophistication.
Yeah, okay. Very subtly.
All right.
Tony taught me that, actually.
31st minute. Germany up by a goal. And it was off a set piece from Gera Frekes. Joy Fawcett coming back for it and heads it away. Parlo chasing it. Parlo's been popping up on all different sides of the field. It's a new surface that they have here in Portland. For more on that, someone who's closer to that surface. Tisha, what do you have?
Yeah, but just prior to the game, some of the players, I asked them how the field was. They said, you know, underneath here is some turf and there's a foam mat laid underneath. Hold on one sec.
Wambach's going to get a corner kick out of this.
Look at Wambach here. This is the workhorse mentality that we were talking about at the top of the show. Ends up getting a corner kick on this cross.
Fifth one for the U.S. Ham is back to take it near sideline. Ham drives it. Off Fawcett. And then who else touched it? Well, referee and referee's assistant looking at one another. Now it's going to be a corner kick. There was some confusion there. Ham will do it again.
These are getting more dangerous.
Ham across the way, and Rottenberg will catch that.
Okay, here's that first corner kick. Rottenberg comes for it. You can see she gets a piece of it. What also goes off Wambach, but they get the corner again. The second corner wasn't taken well enough. It's got to be pulled away from that goalkeeper. Make her make a decision.
Maren Meinert slips it through. Wunderlich right at the byline. And it's a goal kick, says Sonja Denoncourt. Let's get Tisha Hope to finish her story about that surface. Tish.
Thanks, JP. Like I was saying, I asked him about the surface. A lot of them said it's very slow and kind of thick, but the biggest thing, they said it was slick, and I think we've seen that five or six times already with players falling, so that might play into, you know, the outcome of some of these goalkeeper moves or maybe a couple shots. We've seen some people go down pretty easily here today.
Tony, you call a lot of games from this field. Were you seeing that in the other games with players going down?
Well, yes. As a matter of fact, what's happened is there's a synthetic surface underneath that's soft. They put on natural grass over the top of it. The Germans call it a dance floor, but it is a little bit too soft. And as you try to dig in to make a cut, you're just not getting a good push off.
Christine Lilly will play it up the middle. Wambach back for Lilly. USA trailing for the first time in this tournament. Germany after it. And that'll go out for a goal kick. Germany trailed once in this competition. Game one, they gave up a goal to Canada in the fourth minute and then exploded for four goals, and they've never trailed since.
Two things I think the U.S. need to do. One is they need to get their outside backs forward. Now, that isn't really Kate's type of game. She's a defender more than an attacking player. Bivens can do it a little bit better on the other side. And the other thing they need to do is they need to possess the ball in front of the German penalty area. I think if they can get a little bit more possession there, they will find some openings.
Wambach. Ham breaks in. Keeper made the save. Mia's still down. Back for Lilly and off a deflection of goals, but that was the best chance the USA has had. Close call.
Tony, you called that one. You talked about possessing it in front of the German back line, and that's exactly what Abby Wambach did there on that last play, and she finds Mia Hamm in.
What a great diagonal run by Mia. What a great pace ball. And when a striker never has to touch the ball, when they can just look up and see where the goalkeeper is, that's a great pace ball. Now, Rottenberg did make a big-time save on that ball. She's paid the price a bit here. She might have hyperextended her elbow a little bit, but she did make a big save.
Medical staff will come out and take a look. USA number one on ESPN2. We'll have another game on ESPN2 coming up later. Canada and Sweden. That was a good ball.
Here's Wambach making that pass. Mia's got a great run. She doesn't have to touch the ball until she wants to try to beat the keeper. That means the pace of the ball is perfect. It is a good tackle. It isn't a penalty kick. Rottenberg gets to the ball. Mia tries to drag it through. This is just great action. This is just a great soccer game. Both teams putting it all out there.
Corner kick. Rottenberg is back up. She got a piece of that ball, now it's cleared out. That was big, though, that you mentioned, Tony, no penalty kick, because many times with Ham breaking in like that, you're bringing her down, taking the PK. 36th minute, she's still feeling it. Fawcett over to the right side for the U.S. Wiegmann couldn't get it. Foudy up for Harlow, now it's cleared back. Bivens off a block. Shannon Box will go for it. Out on the wing, she was looking for Wambach, and it goes out of play in the 36th minute.
There's a lot of one-way traffic going on now. Just think of the plays that Bryce Curry's had to make and the plays that Rottenberg has had to make. There's a lot of one-way traffic. It's all in Germany's direction. You got to like what the USA is doing right now.
Reddick, nice to win that tackle. And it's cleared out. There's a goal kick coming up.
Wendy, what I think we're seeing now is the Germans just looking for counterattack opportunities.
Well, they're smart to do that and adjust their game. You can see here's Kat Reddick coming over and making a really nice sliding play there on Wiegmann. But you're right, Tony, not typical of Germany wanting to play the long ball, but they've scouted this U.S. system, and that's what they feel is going to get them in. And we talked early on about the fact that the U.S. back line is going to compress the field, and they may get some balls through to players running onto him like Birgit Prinz and Maren Meinert.
Ball played up on that left side. Gottschalk makes another good run. Floats it up there, but Scurry is right there. Brianna with a look upfield and the long kick. Wambach let it go for Parla, who may have called her off on that. Comes back, and a missed kick by Hinkst allows Foudy to bring it down. Julie Foudy will hold. USA down by a goal. Ham to Foudy. Right side. Well-timed run. Harlow will hold it. Crosses for Lily. Looked like she may have been passing that ball across. Goal kick.
Cindy Parlow's getting better on her final pass. Look at this beautiful sighting here on the back post of Christine Lilly, who goes up over Wiegmann, gets a nice header on it. Actually, well struck, trying to bring it down. You see her getting up and trying to bring it down. She takes it back in the direction it came from, which is a good decision on her part, and it just goes wide.
She's going for that far post, and she didn't miss it by much.
On that replay, it looks like she was going for goal. Initially, I thought she was going to play that ball across. Lilly has four shots. Middle, that's cleared away. Fawcett, out of box. It's towards Ham, well read by Stegman. The ball was a bit soft, though, coming through. And then Stegman looking for Prinz, and that one goes out of play.
Well, the German goalkeeper, Rottenberg, has been very busy. She's had to make good saves on good shots. She's had to make a great breakaway save against one of the most terrifying players dribbling at you in the world. She's been very solid so far this half.
Still holding on to that right hand, right wrist area. Flexing the elbow before that. Scoring chances. USA with a huge number and a huge advantage over Germany, but the Germans have the lone goal.
Germany needs to do the same thing I said about the USA. They need to hold the ball in front of the USA defense. They're being a little impatient.
Going long, far side for Wunderlich. And they'll go out of play. It'll be a USA throw-in from deep in their own territory.
Balls like that, they can be a little bit more patient. If they get a little bit patient, maybe they can break down this very, very good American defense. But if they're impatient, this defense will read every pass. Players like Joy Fawcett and her experience will be cutting them out.
39 minutes gone. Germany's holding the ball. Got by Linger. Fawcett's there. Up for Wambach. There is a little bit of space, but Minnick cut it off. They are teammates with the Washington Freedom, where they were this past year. So they know each other's moves. Wambach will take this throw in. Julie Foudy took something off that ball as well. And then fouls. And she's getting a warning from Sonia Denoncourt. She could have gotten the card for that.
Probably should have gotten the card because Maren Meinert is ready to go forward and find a final pass. She has this ball. She's ready to take the next step. And she's pulled back. And that's probably a card. And probably a good foul by Julie Foudy.
I agree, Tony, because she got herself into the trouble on her own because she served a square ball across, which Meinert won, almost set up a counterattack.
Sobrero touched that one last in the air, so Germany will have their third corner kick of this first half.
I'll tell you who the U.S. is having some trouble with, and that's Dara Freitas coming off the right side. She's not just staying in the channel. She's making central runs. She's obviously dangerous on set pieces. And let's see another variation of the German corner kick.
Gottschalk will take it from this near sideline. Germany up 1-0 as the ball comes across. USA will clear it out. Stegman will get it back. Tries to lift it up over Gareth Frekas, but the flag went up on Lindor. 41st minute, Germany leading it. Our coverage of the FIFA Women's World Cup concludes next Sunday. The 2003 final live from the Home Depot Center in Carson, California, 12:30 Eastern next Sunday, noon. On ABC in the third place game Saturday, 3:25 on ESPN2. Here's Lilly chipping it up, and this goes over for a goal kick for Rottenberg.
Those are just too dangerous. Balls are being headed straight up in the air by the German defense. Then they're landing on the ground. The U.S. just needs to be a little bit more patient, and I think they're going to penalize Germany if they get a little bit more hold of the ball.
One in the air by Foudy. The look was for Parlow. 32nd minute. Brought down. Here is Parlow. Carrying it. Pushing it to Wambach. Wambach shot and Rottenberg got a piece. Not all. It's another corner.
I got to tell you, that's a good save by Rottenberg because she's not looking for the ball shot at the near post. She's looking for that ball played across the front. Her positioning was perfect. Let's see what happens with this corner.
Hammers the player open in front. This is Mia taking the corner. A driven ball across. Wambach got that in the air. Ham will get it again. Right at the byline. Drives it across again toward box. It comes off a deflection. Foudy got a crack at it. She'll get another. Pokes it over. The flag went up on Carlo. Offside USA. USA bench didn't think so. Rottenberg will play it up to Bigman. Stegman with it. Tackled away. That was a great effort from Bearded Prince.
Not a good ball by Stegman. She needs to hold the ball a little longer. Find a central midfielder who can find the front runner. This is a little bit better now.
Bigman, Meinert. Nice touches there for the Germans, and here they come. And four up for Prinz. Out wide left is an open player in front, and Meinert just missed. If she deflects that ball, it could be 2-0 Germany.
That's a great piece of soccer right there by the Germans. That ball's played across. Here's Meinert sprinting at the goal. Good defense. I believe that's Kate Sobrero. Kate is one of the great defenders, understanding cover.
And that play started from way up closer to the halfway line. The Germans stringing some passes together.
You can see how dangerous Germany can get. I mean, really, with one and two touches, they're in. And they're just really trying to keep that ball alive. But beautiful, beautiful interplay between Meinert and Prinz. And then Meinert almost gets on the back end of that chance.
Coming back, Germany again. Attacking on the left flank, getting some room. That shot blocked by Foudy off Wunderlich, who's starting to find some space on that wing. And we'll leave it off. 1 minute of stoppage time will be put on. Germany with a one-goal lead, trying to take it in at halftime. or increase it if they can. Off a deflection. Bobby LeClaire up toward Wambach. It got away from her. And was after it. Knocked away. Last touch by Wunderlich.
What the U.S. needs to do, if you notice how much space Minnan is giving Wambach, she doesn't want to have to deal with her, play into Wambach's feet. Let her turn, and then she can face Minnan. Minnan is not a great 1v1 defender. She's a good soccer player.
Meinert touching it up, getting it back from Linger. Maren Meinert will play it back. Across the way, Stegman. Got around Parlow. Playing it back, Hengst. This is Wigman, and now able to face goal. Meinert looking up front. This is Prinz. Off a deflection, Scurry's there. Linger actually made that final pass up the middle. This is Scurry clearing. Doxley missed it. Out it goes, so it belongs to Germany. We're in stoppage time, coming up at halftime on the road with Team USA, plus our first half highlights. And much like 1999, Germany looking like they're going to take a lead against the USA in a halftime. Bivens. Wambach. Still have a half minute to change that scoreline before the half. Bivens. Foudy. Bivens again towards Wambach. And out it goes. Seconds away from the end of the first half, where the USA can talk about perhaps some adjustments at halftime, and Germany can talk about defending the lead that they have. Still a long way from the finish line. Throw-in coming up for Germany with time running out in this first half. That's going to do it. First half has come to a close. Gerhard Frenkes with the only goal from Lingo off a corner kick on the only Germany shot of the first half. A surprising score here because USA has not trailed in this tournament, but they're down 1-0 at the half. ABC and ESPN, the official broadcast partners of the FIFA World Cup and Major League Soccer.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? Because having the right car or truck makes all the difference. Sweetheart, your honey-do list just got a little bit longer. Sorry.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
It's the bottom of the ninth. 4-3. Two on, two out with the entire season in the balance.
Just hang in there.
Games don't come any bigger.
And this one is going right down the wire. The pitch.
Go, go.
He got a hold of it. Hey, yes. It's gone.
The Hyundai Sonata with America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. When you don't miss a thing, you win. Hyundai is an official partner of the FIFA Women's World Cup.
For the journalists who are covering the world's most challenging sporting event for women, Toshiba is supplying PCs to the tournament organizing committee to help them report the news while it's hot. Toshiba, proud to be supporting the FIFA Women's World Cup as official IT partner. Toshiba.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? Because having the right car or truck makes all the difference. Sweetheart, your honey-do list just got a little bit longer. Sorry.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Tuesday.
Did you believe he intended to kill you?
I had no doubt.
One of Blue's own could go down.
Back up or I'll blow his brains out.
New NYPD Blue ABC Tuesday, 10, 9 Central. Viewer discretion advised.
For your next construction job, think Bobcat, the industry standard. Bobcat of Houston sells and rents quality, versatile equipment, but we also offer concrete hand tools for flat work, other specialty tools, parts, attachments, accessories, and of course, our factory-trained technicians. Other dealers may sell Multi-Quip, but we are the authorized repair facility. That means we keep you working. Call or come by and let's talk about your next job. So get the advantage, the Bobcat of Houston advantage.
Why are they calling the war on October 4 the pay-per-view card of the year? Because these guys won't back down.
Evander Holyfield.
They won't back up.
James Toney.
They won't back off. Finally, a heavyweight fight that lives up to the hype. Holyfield Tony, The War on October 4, plus Joel Casamayor versus Diego Corrales, and more. Saturday, October 4th, live on in-demand pay-per-view.
See the heavyweight action live on Time Warner Cable.
Welcome to the Canon Halftime Report, brought to you by Canon. With thousands of products and one simple idea, giving people know-how. Canon know-how.
Heather Mitz, Rob Stone with you for the Canon Halftime Report. We were fortunate enough to be able to go behind the scenes with Team USA during their first round action. So now we go road tripping with the defending Women's World Cup champions.
We're being hurricane chasers right now, heading towards Isabel instead of running from it.
It's going to be so cool. Hopefully our rooms are up high so we can watch the storm coming in.
Actually, I heard that Isabel is easing up. But I heard there's a second hurricane coming, and it's called the U.S. Women's National Team.
Hell yeah!
26 hours from right now, we will be getting off a bus. We'll be coming into this stadium for the World Cup game.
Feel the dreams. Feel the dreams.
The fans are on their way in to RFK Stadium.
You think about the starting game of a World Cup, we're all excited in our bellies. And it's because we're going out to attack that World Cup trophy. We want it more. Make them feel it. Here we go.
She goes inside. Wombach passes. Lily with the goal.
Brandi Chastain is limping. Choosing some pain.
So just we can hold it on
the guy. USA come away with a victory in game one.
Where's the rest of the hoodie?
This game is underway.
Some reminders on Nigeria. They're gonna try to make it an athletic competition for 90 minutes.
This is Ham striking it hard for Parlo, and it went in. USA come away with a victory, 5-0.
You can't feel Brady's shoes. You know, we want her to be back as soon as possible, but I'm just going to do the best I can do.
Nice! Look at this play!
This is awesome!
Jules! This is our breakdance floor.
My name's Mia. What's your name?
Mia Walters.
Well, nice to meet you. You got your A game on?
Oh, yeah.
Stop on your way to Columbus, Ohio.
Well, the fans are ready for it. USA and North Korea getting ready to kick things off.
You sit here with 6 points. No matter what tournament or what year it is, our goal is always to finish first. We're playing to win today, ladies.
So McMillan will drive it across to the middle of the header. And a goal! Reddick's got another. That is it. USA with the game and the group.
Going to the quarterfinals. We're playing Norway. And we are going to play them very hard, and we're going to beat them. And I'm going to go have a Chipotle burrito, so I'm pretty stoked about that.
That looks like more fun than some of my spring breaks. Adidas will be giving away an official game ball from every game of FIFA World Cup 2003 for your chance to win. Log on to adidas.com/ball and enter. Your Aflac trivia question prior to Abby Wambach. Who was the only U.S. player to score in 3 straight games in the same World Cup?
Well, when I got hurt and missed work, glad I had supplemental insurance.
Supplemental insurance? What's that?
Aflac.
Well, even best insurance doesn't give you cash to cover things like lost pay, other expenses. This does.
What does?
Aflac.
Shouldn't ask about it at work.
Really? And what's it called?
Aflac!
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Aflac.
Every few years, the FIFA World Cup needs a communications network that handles anything you throw at it. Where do you find a network like that? In the state of Avaya. We built a network that juggles, converges voice and data, and thousands of IP calls a day. That's why the world's largest sporting event called on Avaya Global Services again. We shoot! We score! You win! Reach Avaya, a higher plane of communication.
You saw your organization's color needs increasing. You knew that adding more single-function color laser printers wasn't going to cut the mustard. You knew it was time to turn to Canon for its color solutions. Now, my friend, it's time to reap the rewards.
Swim class, $60. Hockey camp, $340. Driving lessons, $250. Being able to let go. Being able to let go. Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For parents everywhere, there's MasterCard.
Just 4 years ago, the U.S. women's national team captivated the nation, becoming World Cup champions on home soil. Experience soccer history once again as the 2003 FIFA Women's World Cup returns to this country. Be sure to catch all the action now through October 12th. For tickets, call 1-800-WWC-TIKF. That's 1-800-992-8457.
Tuesday on Playmakers.
You're under arrest for spousal battery.
You're going to suspend me without being found guilty?
The team's got to take a stand.
Playmakers, the hit series, continues Tuesday 9 p.m. on ESPN, preceded by last week's episode at 8.
Your Aflac trivia question prior to Abby Wambach, who is the only U.S. player to score in three straight games in the same World Cup. Go back to 1991. Your answer, Michelle Akers. The U.S. has now trailed only three times at half in women's World Cup play. Number three right now in Portland, U.S. in a 1-0 hole. And Heather, what do they have to do in the second half to try and get back in this?
Well, the U.S. has outshot Germany so far in this game. Right now, they need more through balls. We saw one great opportunity in the game where Abby Wambach faces up and plays a through ball to Mia Hamm. Definitely the most dangerous opportunity in the game. If they can continue to do that, I think they will be successful here in the second half.
U.S. out shooting Germany 8-1. Cindy Parlow has been very effective, but again, the bottom line, big zero in the box score. Second half action coming your way. Germany with a 1-0 lead. U.S. hasn't lost to Germany since October of 97. They're in a 1-0 hole now.
Hello?
Hey, honey. Now, don't forget to pick up the dog.
Me? Forget?
Now there's a phone you can use as a wireless or as a walkie-talkie.
Hey, Gina, when do we record?
Noon.
Oh, thanks.
Now at Radio Shack, get a Verizon Wireless Motorola V60P, a push-to-talk wireless phone for just $149.99.
Hey, Vanessa.
Rick, you didn't remember.
Delivery, Miss Williams.
Vanessa.
Oh.
Radio Shack.
They said its off-road capabilities verged on overkill.
Torag.
They said others may be as quick, capable, and handle as sharply, but few can match it on all of the above.
Torag.
They said it was everything you could want in a luxury SUV, but for 20 grand less. In fact, the only thing the experts couldn't say...
Touareg.
Tural.
Twarg.
...was the name.
Touareg.
Introducing the Touareg. Easily named car and driver's best luxury SUV for 2003.
Hello.
Hey, it's Susie. I'm in the neighborhood. I thought I'd stop by.
I don't know if that's a good idea. My place is kind of,
I've got some Bud Light.
Come on up.
Nice place.
Thanks. I'll put this in the fridge. Make yourself at home.
Okay.
With a great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
A bowling ball.
Make it a Bud Light.
Hockey's opening night. America, lace them up tight. Everyone has a chance to be a champion. NHL opening night. Regional coverage. 8 p.m. Wednesday on ESPN.
Thank you.
to order high definition programming, call 713-341-1000.
This is it, Houston. Your last chance to pay zero initiation and join the all-new Inwood Forest Country Club. Amenities include free range balls and use of the practice facilities, gourmet dining, a fabulous members-only grill, and first-class locker rooms for the ladies and gents. This opportunity will never be repeated. From now to October 31st, you can join Inwood Forest Country Club free.
Call 281-448-0223. Schedule a tour.
ESPN2's coverage of the 2003 FIFA Women's World Cup is brought to you by MasterCard. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Hyundai, when your car comes with America's best warranty, you win. Hyundai, Avaya, a higher plane of communication. Bud Light, official beer of the U.S. Women's National Soccer Team. And by Time Warner Cable, now anything's possible.
Back to Portland, Oregon, where in the semifinal match, Germany leads the United States by the score of 1-0 in front of a sellout crowd at PGE Park here in Portland. Welcome back, everyone, here at halftime, along with Wendy Guevara Palladino, Antonio DiCicco. I'm JP Della Camera. USA has outshot Germany and outchanced them, Tony, but the Germans have the only goal of the match.
Well, and it was a great goal. It was a ball that was served in by Lingor, driven into the near post. Garofrakis gets her head on it, puts it off the underside of the crossbar, and gives them the lead.
And then the U.S. mounted some nice attacks, but it was really Rottenberg that was making some really big saves. She had a wonderful first half for Germany.
So the USA find themselves in a different spot here, trailing 1-0. And Tony, let's look and see where the attacks are coming from, and what can you make out of where the USA and Germany, for that matter, is attacking?
Well, you can take a look here in the middle and in the right side of the USA attack. 17 of 22 have taken place. Germany struggling on the left side of their defense. Coach Tina Toyn-Meyer has to make an adjustment there. Parlo, Mia, they all had opportunities to get around the flank. They just didn't connect in the penalty area.
No subs out there for either side, at least not at the start of this second half. Meinert bringing it down. Left side, Wunderlich. Running it against Patty Bibbins on the far side. Binger played it back. The long ball. And scores right underneath it. And a long one from Gottschalk. We can only wonder what was going on at halftime in these two dressing rooms. Let's get an update on the U.S. from Tisha Hope.
Apparently, a lot of the halftime chat came from Julie Foudy, who was the captain. She said, you know, they're about to crack. Let's keep pushing. We can feel it. And everybody chimed in. We can feel it. They're going to crack. Let's keep attacking. JP.
Thanks, Tish. Tony, do you remember that halftime chat last time against Germany in the World Cup?
Very well. And that has been, let's watch this attack by Mia first.
It's inside, and Wiegmann's going to sweep it away.
Again, that's from the right side of the U.S. attack, left side of the German defense. But that has been Germany's problem in the past. They haven't been able to stay with the USA mentality. Can they do it today?
Ham with another cross. Running onto it. Lilly settles, trying to cut inside and go to the right foot, but Stegman denied her. And it's going to be picked up by Hinkst on the far side. Gave it away to Fox. Wiegmann will take it over. Germany back with it. I'd like to thank Bud Light and all of our sponsors for allowing us to bring you this FIFA Women's World Cup without interruption. USA will have a throw in on the near side. Garofrakis has the only goal of the match. Came off a corner kick. Germany leads 1-0. Winner goes on to the final. The loser plays in that third place match next weekend. Foudy with it, and then the low cross is blocked. And again, that started in the right flank. Germany coming back on this left side, and that one's denied. But a foul in the U.S. on Bibbins. That brought April Heinrichs right up off the bench.
Here's Julie Foudy's cross here and what they were looking for. Whoa, wow, handball, absolutely. And that's what the crowd was booing about on Julie Foudy's cross. A German defender slowed that ball down with her right hand.
That's not legal, is it, Wendy?
No.
Changed a bit.
One of those subtle things you teach the forwards. Which I was on the fence that time, right, Tony?
Twins off a block from Meinert. Hard to believe that Meinert and Prinz have not had a big game, yet Germany is up. A goal in their only shot. Wunderlich played it back. This is Maren Meinert. Probably the most dangerous player on the field for Germany. Here's a long shot high and over. Story from Stegmann. Meinert, the MVP this past season in the WSA, announced her retirement from international play, and then she came back.
Now, both teams, both coaches have made good adjustments. Both teams are trying to possess the ball in front of the other team's penalty area. We're seeing it. If they do that, we're going to have more scoring opportunities by both teams.
Fawcett played it up. Coming back after it, Joy Fawcett will clear. While the USA continues to attack and press forward to look for the tying goal, the one thing they must be wary of is Germany on a counterattack and falling down 2-0. That could spell big trouble in this kind of an environment, the way Germany has played through this World Cup. Off Fawcett. Ham trying to keep it alive. And the ball is whistled down. On the handball. Bivens will put it back into play. Johnny Bivens from the Atlanta Beat playing it up long. Matted up by Wambach. And Germany again will play it safe when they've had that opportunity. Would rather clear it out to the side like that. Going deep for the USA.
Hengst and Minnert in the center of the German defense have done a good job of covering for each other.
Harlow, a touch that's too much. And it results in a goal kick for Rottenberg. Allie Wagner has been up, warming up. And she appears to be the first sub for the USA. So they will bring her in the playmaker role. And we'll see if they change formation or just switch players.
And this is exactly supporting, Tony, what you've been saying, that that's where the U.S. needs to possess the balls in front of the German back line, and that's what Allie Wagner does so well.
Now, my guess would be, Wendy, that Box may come out, Foudy may drop into that space, and now Wagner is going to drop in right behind the front runners.
Ball play back to Brianna Scurry. Scurry will hold on and now find Joy Fawcett. Jennifer Carlo, she got cracked there by Gottschalk. Carlo has it tackled away. Gottschalk kept it alive. Wunderlich. This is Linger. Jennifer Meinert, that's broken up. Carlo coming back. Ham is free on the right wing. Carlo to Ham, who stayed onside. Mia looks up to cross and got underneath it. And it'll be a goal kick, and now we'll see the substitution, but it's Carlo's number that's up. So Allie Wagner will come in for Cindy Parlo. Maybe the USA goes to a 4-4-2. We'll see how they play it. But Tony, this is the first time, I think, during this World Cup that the USA has had to really make a tactical substitution for this reason. Their subs in this tournament have been the rest players for the most part.
I just like the way Cindy's been playing. I think she's given them a lot. She gives them a lot of bite. She keeps balls alive in the attacking third. And
Prince is going to come back. Not a doubt, a double header. That was scary. Gareth Frekes was there again. Fourth one on the corner for Germany.
This is what the Germans do so well. They're not going to get as many chances as the U.S., but that ball is bent right in, and it's right on a player sprinting towards the goal, right on her head. Luckily, deflected off a USA defender.
Gottschalk will get ready to take this corner. Deflections can cause you all kinds of problems, and nearly did for the U.S. A driven ball across. Prinz, what a save from Scurry, and a rebound. She stopped that too. The USA are able to clear it out, but if they come back and win this game, mark it there. We've got an injured Germany player in the box. It's Prinz, and now Box takes it upfield. Those are two spectacular plays Brianna Scurry made. Another Germany player is down somewhere else upfield. Looks like Linger. But play is continuing. No one is aware of it. So the USA is not clearing it out. And the referee's not stopping play.
Here's the ball played across, and Rottenberg's got it. It's a shoulder injury to Linger. But somebody's got to see this now, and the Germans finally do. And it's cleared out.
That could be it.
That could be serious.
Brian Escurry came up huge. Look at Birgit Prinz diving header there. Brian Escurry saves it, makes the first save. Ball still bouncing around, gets back up, makes the second save. Here's the next save coming in here. Still can't hang on to it. Just trying to get it out so her defenders can make a clearance on it.
Tony is an ex-goalkeeper. That second save, tougher than the first.
Well, you know, Brianna Scurry sets herself apart with saves like that. It's agility, it's athleticism. Yes, it's good positioning, but here we see the injury, and looked like she did hurt her shoulder as she was falling over on by Julie Foudy, not intentionally. But just great positioning by Bry, but then the ability to make a save beyond the ground to get up and be on balance enough to extend somewhere to make another save. That is so uncommon in goalkeepers. That's why she's the best in the world. And how important are those two saves for the USA right now?
They're critical because it gives the USA a chance. Going down 2-0 could be a very deep hole, even for a team as talented as this USA squad is. Here is Wagner holding it. Scurry may have to do even more of that with the USA continuing to press forward to look for a tying goal.
A little bit of a nervous touch there by Allie Wagner.
And again, Brianna Scurry. Again, look at this athleticism. Great positioning on the first save there. Then a reflexive save there. Again, just trying to keep the ball on the back of the net. She had her defenders tucking in behind her on the post. Well organized by this U.S. defense.
So many goalkeepers can make that first save, but it's that second one. She got herself in a position to do it. And that's why her teammates have so much confidence in her.
You got to remember, after the first save, she's on the ground. The ball is ricocheting around. She's got to get up. She's got to have balance to make the second save. That's special athleticism right there. That separates Brianna Scurry from any other goalkeeper in the world.
Jim, the midfielder, is back on the field. Renata Linger, a hard landing on the right shoulder. USA will clear that ball out. Germany will have a throw-in deep in the 56th minute. Germany leading 1-0 on a Gerhard Freckes goal off a corner kick from Linger, and it came in the 15th minute. This is Gerhard Freckes who will take the throw-in on Wigman, settled by Linger, right foot, and that one goes wide and scored.
Chippy, I'd love to chat with Tony for a sec about the Parlo sub. Tony, I agree with you that Parlo was playing so well, but I think one thing that we have to keep in mind is she's not a 90-minute player. So if the U.S. has to use one of their subs, you know, the question, do you bring Wambach out or do you bring Parlo out? You've got to leave Mia Hamm on the field, but I do. I love the way Parlo was playing that first half. She was the one player up top that consistently was possessing the ball very, very well.
Well, she was creating all kinds of problems for him. And you know, I've never made a bad coaching move from the broadcast booth, but I just thought that Julie could step in and play Box's position. We add another attacking personality to the game.
This is Wagner. Nice cutting ball for Lily. Christine Lily wide left. Hangs it up towards Hamm. Rottenberg's got it, and no rebound, and another tough landing for Silke Rottenberg. Playing well today.
That's a good cross, because that's not an easy ball to track down. Rottenberg is playing as well as I've ever seen her play. She's had to make some big, big saves.
Push off there as Box was fouled by Maren Meinert.
Here, Tony, I think the adjustment the U.S. needs to make on their crosses is they've seen that Rottenberg can dominate the box. They've got to pull it out even farther than they normally would.
Make her have to. You're right, Wendy. Make goalkeepers have to make difficult decisions. That's when you find out who can make the play and who can't. I think we've got some marathoners that are still finishing the course here.
And obviously we're not showing them on camera, which is the correct decision. I was wondering what all the cheering was about. Well, just when you thought you saw everything, Tony, you see stuff, well, you see too much.
Yeah, the Portland Marathon took place early this morning, and for some, it probably was a longer trek than for others, so some are just finishing the race now.
But, Tony, in that marathon, those runners were clothed, I believe. I hope.
I thought that was one of the rules.
Shorts, sneakers, mandatory.
58th minute. A lot going on in Portland today. We mentioned the marathon, and then this game today. They're saying that some 38,000 people will be downtown today in Portland for all that's going on. Back to the game, thankfully. Right side, it's Ham. Cutting. Knocked away. Gottschalk did well. You don't want to, you're the Germans, you don't want to be isolated 1v1 there against Mia Hamm.
No, but I like the way Mia took the ball right at her. That's what she needs to do. Mia needs to get the ball in the penalty area, force her to try to tackle her in the penalty area.
Body scrambling after this. Wunderlich has got it. Up the side it comes. Birgit Prinz. Joy Fawcett is there. Couldn't get that ball to Foudy, though. Winger clears up for Meinert. Box helps to defend, and Bivens breaks it up. That was handled by Prinz. Baker coming up for the USA with Bivens.
Wendy, the USA has come out very strong. They're down a goal. You know their mentality. They're going to put everything forward. Right now, the Germans have been able to hold their own against them.
Well, it's certainly going to help them if they can convert on one of these chances that Julie Foudy talked about, how they're cracking. We've got them, she said, at halftime. But, you know, it doesn't matter if they let Germany settle into the second half. That's got to happen real soon.
Wagner, that's a good ball. Frees Ham on the wing. Ham, quick cross. Rottenberg got it. A driven cross, but Rottenberg just reacted very well and got there before Wambach did.
Again. Go, Tony. I know you're going to say the same thing that
it's
I was.
It's all happening down the same side here. I'm not sure if that's a German strategy. We'll let them play on the right side and we'll cover everybody else in the center of the defense. I'm not sure, but it's happening all down the right side. And it's good that Mia for the U.S. is on that side now.
Winger plays it over. This is Wunderlich, and the flag is up. Germany are offside.
Here's that box by Rottenberg. This is another courageous play. Of course, Wambach's in there challenging for it, as she always will be, so that's good goalkeeping.
Ball is played long down the middle, and Rottenberg headed it out. Couldn't use her hands there. One of her teammates is down. As play continues, she just hit her own teammate when she came out aggressively, and now play is stopped. In the 61st minute.
Here's Rottenberg coming out. She's out of the penalty area. She can't use her hands. So she collides with, I believe that's God. She collides with, and that's a pretty hard collision right there. He looks a little dazed, but again, that's good goalkeeping. Rottenberg, right now, in my opinion, is the key player for the German team.
We can't stress enough in analyzing the crosses. She's obviously playing very, very strong, at least 10 yards out. The U.S. is going to have to mix it up. Those crosses that Rottenberg is handling easily, Tony, like you said, they've got to put them out of her reach to make her commit and make a decision. These crosses for her right now are coming easily to her.
And where you do that is you drive them hard near post, or you drive them to the back post. Those are the areas where the goalkeeper has the toughest time reaching balls, or out farther in front.
Off the interception, Wagner towards Ham, and again Rottenberg is there. Short-handed though, Tony, on everything tonight.
Well, another good play, but I'll tell you what, that was a great pass by Wagner, because that ball had Mia on the end of it right from the start.
Back the other way, Germany at the other end with Birgit Prinz inside the box. Here's the cross over Bivens, but far enough so that the USA can recover. Oh, nice turn by Wunderlich. Another cross driven away and knocked out by Sobrero for a corner kick.
That's the right play by Kate Sobrero. Don't try to clear that when your defense is totally disorganized. Get your defense organized. You got Brianna Scurry in goal. You got Abby Wamba that can head balls out. Now you're organized. Yes, you got to play a corner kick, but you prefer the organization.
And behind them, looking on at Germany's fifth corner kick of the match. Driven across, and there's Scurry. But that was whistled down anyway. Something else was happening inside the box. So Sonia Benoncourt stops play.
get a chance to see Bry's range on that, because that was a driven cross, not an easy ball, and she just came and made it look very routine.
Ball flipped up into space. Fowdy's not able to get there. Ham is now on the opposite side of the field. Bivens won the ball, wins it a second time. Kylie Bivens looking up, finding Ham. She saw her anyway, but the ball finds its way to Ruttenberg instead.
It's a good look, just the texture, weight of the final pass wasn't good enough.
And ball the other way. 74 Prince brought down. Here's Germany. Garofrekas, nice idea, and a nice ball as well. Wunderlich, she let that ball run out anyway. On the sideline, right at the end line, actually.
I like Garofrekas because she comes into the middle of the field. She comes off the flank. She comes into the middle of the field, adding numbers to the central attacking posture of the Germans, and it's tough to deal with.
Wambach. They're going to find Gottschalk. Reflection. Wambach goes in hard. So does Ham. Mia pokes it ahead, and she's free on the right. Ham with a look up. She will get a corner kick for the USA.
And that's an example of good team defense. Mia Ham comes back into the midfield to help her teammates win that ball.
10th USA corner kick. They've done well in the East throughout the tournament. Nothing so far today. Ham strikes it. Headed up by Wambach. She got to it, but bit awkwardly, and it goes over the top.
I do like one of the adjustments that Coach Heinrichs has made, and that is to get Mia on the right side.
Here's a look at this corner kick opportunity. Ball's driven in nicely by Mia Ham. Wambach goes up. Didn't head it very well there. You could tell she tried to flick it. Didn't get a good head on it. But the key for the U.S. is going to be to convert on one of these set pieces or get a goal. Get a goal soon, because Germany's hanging in there.
65 minutes gone. Germany still leading over the USA. 1-0. As Ham is ready. From about 45 on.
Watch Wombat on this.
So up. And now Germany's going to get that off Big Mum's chest. Picked off. This is Wagner. Good footwork. Then the last pass was not a good one. Stegman intercepts. Toss it, nudge it down. A block. USA getting it back. And Fowdy, broken up by Wunderlich. Garofrekas, bumped by Sobrero. It's up to Prinz against Foster. Nice turn on her. Big, and Prinz comes in. Referee has stopped play, but I think she's going to call it right outside the area on that foul. Minot was appealing for a penalty kick. This is a great move.
You don't see Joy Fawcett get turned very often. Here she does. The call was the right call. It happened just outside the area. Key coverage by Kat Reddick. But this is how dangerous Birgit Prinz is when she's going to goal. And this is a dangerous situation because there's two or three or ten Germans that can strike this ball into the back of the net. Maren Meinert comes to mind right away.
Minger is the deepest player. She'll strike it through, and it went through the wall, but wide of Scurry.
Here's Prinz coming at Joy Fawcett. She turns her around. She breaks into the penalty area. It's close. It's close, but I think it was just outside the area. Good call by the Canadian referee. And the U.S. dodged the bullet right there.
And a great job by Catherine Reddick to come in and cover for Joy Fawcett. That was just a critical play that she made there, not allowing Birgit Prinz to get in for a free shot.
She's not there. Bivens was fairly close, but did not have a good angle. Prinz would have actually had a breakaway. Coming up, the Canadians looking on. They'll be taking on Team Sweden live at 10:25 here on ESPN2 in the same venue, same network. So join us later on. Canada, the surprise of this World Cup. Best place last time.
One way to stop Wambach.
68th minute.
Wambach has been a dominating player in these past few games, and so far the USA has not been able to find her, Wendy, in good positions.
Well, I think this German defense is keeping a close eye on her. One thing that I'm not seeing out of her that we naturally saw out of her in the last number of games was her workhorse mentality. She doesn't seem to be working quite as hard to try and maybe put this defense of Germany under more pressure, and a lot of times if you do the defensive part, the offensive part comes to you.
This is Foudy, tripped up by Maren Miner. She knew it. Free kick, USA. Nearly 68 minutes gone here. Good play. Bivens hangs it up. Rottenberg, not a good position. Wambach cracked into her. And they were going to call a foul anyway on Abby Wambach. Rottenberg was vulnerable the way she went up there at that angle. Look at her.
Beautiful ball in the box there. Bivens sends it really deep. Why not mix it up? And Wambach is the player that runs hard into Rottenberg. That's going to shake her up a bit. We'll see how she recovers from this.
It's the right call. Rottenberg is going straight up for the ball. And here comes a player that's charging in. But it's a statement that Wambach and the USA are making, that their fighting power is just beginning. And that's the key still to me. Can the Germans match the USA fighting power?
Reddick will play it long. Tiffany Milbert is up on the sideline, getting ready to sub in. So the USA will make their second of three allowed subs as we have a goal kick coming up. And for Tiffany Milbert, she'll get to play in front of the home crowd because she went to the University of Portland. And there is Tiffany. And Kylie Bivens is coming out, so do we see three in the back?
Yep. Kat Reddick will come to the right side of the back. Joy will stay in the center. Kate will have the left. And now we've added another attacking personality, and what an attacking personality. Tiffany Milbert, what a story. She's playing in her hometown, and this is going to be another challenge for the German defense.
And the U.S. back line has gone into three players in the back, so they're going to play a 3-4-3.
How the Germans attack it too, and they've got another player down at the other end, right at the top of the arc. The German players are falling like crazy here, and that's Meinert who's down, slowly getting back up. Here's a long ball for Milbert. She's taken down. It's got to be a penalty. There's no flag up. Sonja Denoncourt looks like she was looking at the other official.
Here comes the ball into the penalty area. Milbert's going for it. She gets a touch. She gets hammered. It's in the penalty area. And the U.S. gets a throw-in. It's a bad call. I think it is a penalty kick, but a tough one to make for the referee.
Hamill played across, and that one's cleared away.
Tony, I agree with you. That was a bad call not to call a penalty kick there because Milbert was completely stopped. Rottenberg did not play any part of that ball. She just took Milbert out.
Yeah, Milbert played the ball. She got the touch. And then here comes the goalkeeper in late. Now, any place else on the field, that's clearly a foul and probably a card. In the penalty area, the referee's still got to make that tough call. Not an easy call, but I think Germany dodged the bullet there.
I saw her looking to the side, and I thought she was looking to see if the referee's assistant had something else up, like a flag to indicate maybe she saw better.
Well, I don't,
just looking at the throw.
I think that's a great statement, JP, because I don't think the referee's assistant helped her on that call.
Coming back, it's Wambach. Milbert sprints upfield. Wambach running at the defense. That's the kind of running, Wendy, that you were talking about before that we haven't seen in this game. But she needs more of it.
Well, every single U.S. player on this team's got to just take it up another level.
Flags up on Ham as she played it back, and Milbert put it upstairs anyway, but it was offside. Milbert would have been the last to know. She had never seen the flag go up.
Here's the ball through. Mia Hamm is in behind the defense there. That's where they were calling offsides even before the cross was put across the face of the goal there. Even though that play was called back, Milbert's got to focus on those chances so that she's ready for the next one that comes her way.
And we can argue whether that is offsides or not. You know, I'm a believer that unless you're sure it's offside, keep your flag down. We want to see attacking soccer and not just free kicks. But let me tell you something. That combination of Hamm and Milbert, we're going to see more of in this game.
73rd minute. Sobrero on it. Up for Wambach. Headed it toward goal, and Wattenberg's there. Wambach's starting to get more active here. Wunderlich
in the middle. Meinert with a touchback.
No flag.
Offside. Yes, it is. Now it's up. Offside on Prinz.
And the Germans are doing what they need to do. They're trying to possess the ball. But what they've got to do is change the point of attack. The U.S. obviously now is the three back. They're going to come strong to the ball side. So now the Germans need to change the point of attack, get it to the other side, and buy some time for themselves.
Sombrero carries it in. But that one's blocked and cleared out. Here comes Germany. Right, it's so skillful on the ball. That pass will fail. She's looking for Prinz.
74th minute, a lot of pressure here on the USA. Tish, what do you have on the sideline?
Well, the pressure is definitely building down here. I talked to Julie Foudy a couple days ago about how the U.S. deals with pressure, and she says, we thrive on pressure. We live for games and moments like this that they're in right now, and boy, they're feeling this pressure. Let's see what they can do with it.
Fox gets fouled. You would think, because the way this game has been played, Wendy, I thought in a closer game, USA had an advantage because of the tougher games that they've played. Germany's not been contested in a lot of these games, but right now, it's Germany up.
Well, it's a different story because Germany is up 1-0, and there's a lot of time left. We should emphasize that, but that's kind of the fine line that these players have to balance, is they've got to keep the pressure on this German team, but they also have to be very patient on their chances.
Germany didn't play a team in the top 10. USA played three in the top seven. That's a big difference. Germany didn't have to travel. They were playing here in Portland. That's one advantage. But the USA has been chartering. And all the players said they were not tired. We spoke to them yesterday. So they were feeling good. Here's Wambach leaving it off to Wagner. She tried to finesse that ball through to Wambach. Germany had plenty of players back in cover. It's up for Prinz. Birgit will hold. Plays it back. Germany now attacking on that counter. Gera Frekes again. He seems to be able to find the spaces. Third upfield, Ham, and get right away to Begman. Begman's pass back, and now it's Lindfort. She'll carry it. Linger stepping in, Kat Reddick stumbled, then got right back up. Gera Frekes, none of that challenge. Here's the Prinz to Wunderlich. Birgit Prinz playing it out. Nice give and go. Prinz with a shot that's low and right at Brian Ascari, but it looked very dangerous there for Germany.
Right now, Germany's doing a very good job of playing in front of the U.S. defensive line. That's what, Tony, you've mentioned that a number of times. That's key for both sides, and right now I'm feeling like Germany's doing a better job of that. They're having very good possession in that area. It's putting this U.S. three-man back under a lot of pressure.
Ball getting through, and Fawcett couldn't take a chance there with Prinz bearing down on her. She won't give up a corner. She's going to throw in deep.
You're right, Wendy, and that's the gamble you make. And Coach Heinrichs has made the right decision. Let's get another attacking personality. But by doing that, we're giving the dangerous German players a little bit more room in their attacking zone. And Scurry, Fawcett, and the rest of the crew are going to have to make up the difference.
Weiner trying to put that one up. 76th minute, so about 15 minutes and some change, depending on stoppage time, left for the USA to avoid having to play in the third place game. They've got a winning record against Germany. They've lost only one time. Tony, you remember that one back in 95 in the World Cup in Sweden against Norway. This crowd's not ready to give up, certainly. The USA are in a tough spot here. Plenty of time left. But they need a finish. Ham is broken up. Fox. And it goes upstairs.
The keys for the game, when I looked at what Germany needed to do, they needed to match the fighting power of the USA. So far, they're doing that. They needed to prevent set pieces. Goals on set pieces. So far, they're doing that. And they needed to possess the ball and prevent the USA from closing them down and forcing them into just a combative game. And they're doing a pretty good job of that as well.
And they got a bonus when they scored off the set piece earlier in their only shot of the first half.
And their bonus is the play of Rottenberg. That's where their bonus is coming from.
Here is Wambach at the other end. This cross up, one miss. It's a loose ball. Picked up and blocked. It was off Wagner's shot. Foudy. And that one was blocked at the edge of the box. And here comes Germany coming back. With some numbers. And the dangerous Meinert leading it. Right side it comes towards Wigman. who hasn't gone up this far during the game, but saw the opportunity, plays it for Prinz, and fortunately for the United States, she put it upstairs because she was open.
She had a diving header in the earlier on in this game.
Here's that ball into Milbritt. She gets a little flick to it. I think it's Lil on the backside. I'm not sure, Christine Lilly. The ball comes out. Somebody else gets a whack at it. This is just great attacking soccer by two outstanding teams.
German player goes down again after getting hit in the face with the ball. It's Minertz, who is down on the field. And again, the training staff will come out. Germany leads the United States 1-0. They've not beaten the USA since 1997. And not here since the early 90s.
Here's a look at the injury. Christine Lilly going in hard. Player just took the ball in her face, it looked to me like. And two U.S. players there battling hard, Christine Lilly and Mia Hamm.
Lil tries to play it over the top, and it's right into Sandra Minnich's face. Looks like she got it in the nose and mouth area.
And the USA has had some chances, but it's Rottenberg that has come up huge. The U.S. is having all kinds of trouble converting on any of their chances, and in that case there, I think Christine Lilly slipped a bit on this surface that's been causing both teams some trouble.
That is the hottest goalkeeper that the USA have run into during this World Cup. Other goalkeepers have made big saves, Nordby the other night, but look at all the scoring chances for the USA. Not quite doubling Germany, but close. Box breaking it up. Milbert was in a good spot. They couldn't get the ball to her. Nearly given away that time. Towards Lombard. Comes up. Now Box brings it down. Now the pressure builds. 80th minute. And the USA still down by one. But they wouldn't even be in this spot had Skorjedan made two big saves a long way back in this half. Otherwise, Germany would have had a 2-0 lead. Minute is back in. Milbert played it over. Lombard. Holds outside. Lilly, the cross was blocked. USA must scramble back and get this. And it'll go out for USA throw-in.
I like the runs Milbert is making. She's making runs at the restraining line. They've got to keep, the U.S. has got to keep looking for Milbert.
There's Garofrekas running right at the heart of the defense. And wide open was Minert.
He held it too long, JP.
Yeah, without a doubt. Here's Hamm coming back. Trying to find Milbert. That's knocked out of play. Here is Hamm. Can Germany continue to hold on here and get the upset victory? We'll find out in another 10 minutes' time as Box picks it off. Here's Hamm. Looking, sending it in front, it's blocked. Hamm will get it back. Slipped as she cut. Milbert keeps it alive. Down she goes. Free kick in a good spot for the USA.
I think Mia tried to get a shot off but slipped. That's where that surface worked against her. She was ready to drive it left footed, probably for the far post, but slipped. But Milbert fouling it up creates this free kick opportunity. Again, it's one of the keys for the Germans if they're going to stay in this game.
Hamm drives it across. And that one gets through for a goal kick, apparently.
Looking for Wombat and Box on that backside. But the Germans did a good job of marking players, making sure no one has free runs at one of those head balls.
82nd minute. USA have made a couple of subs. Obviously, they can make one more. Right now, they like the way they're attacking, but they're not finishing. Brought down. Milbert couldn't get to it. Germany can.
What's dangerous, JP, Wendy, is the Germans are starting to get some looks at goal as well. And that second offside call, that second goal could come from Germany, and that's what's dangerous. The U.S. is pushing forward, pushing forward, pushing forward. The Germans know how to counterattack.
And although Julie Foudy says we thrive under pressure, the U.S. team loves that. It's tougher, Tony, when they're watching this German team get chance after chance on counterattacks.
Wagner, that was bobbled, but there's nobody in the neighborhood for the USA.
Okay, on this replay, Rottenberg is slightly out of position. She's backpedaling as that shot is taken. That's why she didn't get it cleanly.
Scurry at the other end. 83rd minute. An upset in the making with Germany leading the United States, the defending champions. A team that's unbeaten in this country in their last 28 games. You'd have to go back to the year 2000 for their last loss on home territory. This foul will give Germany a free kick, which will allow them to take some more seconds off the clock. On any free kick, corner kick, throw-in, they'll take their time.
I'd like to see Coach Heinrichs maybe get Danielle Slayton in, who can get up and down the flank for Kate Sobrero and add a little bit of attacking flair, be a little bit more dangerous on balls, flight it into the box because she'll bend them in left-footed, and she's got great speed. I assume she's healthy. Wendy, do you know, can you give an update on that?
Well, actually, Tony, we've, you know, followed this U.S. team the whole way, and unfortunately for the U.S., when Slayton is healthy, she's the best left back that this country has, but she is not healthy. Her knees are just giving her a ton of trouble, and actually early on in the tournament, the U.S. was completely resting her in training, so she did play a bit in one game, but she has not been there for this U.S. team because her knees are really giving her a ton of trouble.
Was going after him. It's a USA foul. What a quick restart for Germany.
Offside.
Flex up. Wow. That's where a quick restart, though, could kill you. Germany was smart, except they went offside. But they were smart to try to execute the free kick at that time quickly. Tina Toynmeyer knows how big an upset this can be. But it's not over yet. And you've got to figure there's still another chance or two left before the USA will go down in this one. 85th minute.
That's the attack that they have to do now. They've got to flight balls into Wambach and have players running off of her.
But I think her flicks, Tony, have got to be away from the goalkeeper. She's just helping Rottenberg out and making those saves.
Good point.
Right down the middle. Lindgren's pass. A little scurry. That's as worried as I've ever seen the USA bench look. They still appear to have hope, but they look worried. Taken away now by Germany. Miner to the right. Garofrekas looking over for Prinz, but Fawcett was right there with Birgit Prinz, nullifying the potential danger. 86th minute. Wambach leaves it off to try to catch up to this ball from Wagner. And Germany shouldn't have given one up there. That's a deep throw in. They have two against one. Long throw in. Wambach trying to flick it over. Ham fighting for it. Near the byline, Hingst will clear it. Garofrekas has it blocked. It stays in play. And then Germany will clear it. There's some contact there right at the byline. No foul is going to be called. It'll be a USA throw-in.
Watch Julie Foudy on the back post.
Coming up, Rottenberg punched it out. Wagner. Box drives it upstairs into the crowd. Still 1-0, Germany. Garofrekas with the only goal. Rottenberg. Germany have to play it carefully and hope that they can avoid any kind of a mistake, especially when it's deep in their end. And then two heads collide. Wigman thinking of her own teammate. She's down. Quick throw in. We should have stopped play. She was down and hurt.
Yeah, they collided heads. I'm trying to think as a coach here.
Here's a replay of this collision. Two German players go in on the ball and they head each other. Wigman goes down hard on that.
Seventh minute, Germany leading 1-0. Our coverage of the FIFA Women's World Cup concludes next Sunday with a 2003 final live from the Home Depot Center in Carson, California. Sunday at 12:30 Eastern, 9:30 Pacific on ABC Sports. Saturday, the third place match is coming your way as well. That's on ESPN2. And unless the USA gets a goal soon, they'll be in that third place match. Milbrick
cutting inside. Milbert with a shot or pass. Tough to tell. Ham was open at the back post. Looked like something in between.
You gotta love the way she went into the penalty area, though. That's Tiffany Milbert. See how she splits two defenders. This is a shot.
Yep.
She's looking to score on that back post. So here's the move, Wendy, that I would be making. I take Fox out, I move Bowdy into that spot, and I get McMillan into the game.
Tony, I agree with you. When she came into the game against North Korea, she did a great job. Had a quick assist. Actually had a goal that ended up being called back.
Just checking to see if anybody's up. I don't see anybody up warming up. Quick throw in from that far side. And Germany will clear it.
Bossett will get it back. We're in the 89th minute. Germany looking to upset the defending champions. And this would be, as good a team as Germany is, this is a big upset if Germany wins. Down this right side. Milbert. To the end line. The cross. Another corner. Some life in the USA legs.
Excellent run by Tiffany Milbert. Bent run into the space. And then she did what she needs to do. Go right at the defender.
The most important corner kick of this match is coming up now. Ham drives it. Rottenberg lost it, but Germany with Minnert could clear it. And then Sobrero shanked it out. 90th minute now. Stoppage time will become critical.
I keep looking to see if there's somebody ready to go in from the USA bench.
Nobody up. They're going with what they have. In the 90th minute, they've run into a hot goalkeeper today. You could say that the USA has not done their part as well in terms of some of the finishing. And full credit to Germany for the way they've played here today. 3 minutes of stoppage time. Here is Wunderlich. Up for Prinz. This is the closest game Germany's been involved with in this World Cup, and they're up. Wunderlich across. That could finish it off, but it's cleared away and given right back, though, to Prinz. USA winning it on that tackle from Wagner, then losing it back. Quick shot wide by Linger.
See how dangerous the Germans are when they get a contact opportunity.
3 minutes left in the USA's hopes of defending their World Cup. They lose this, they're in the third place match against the winner of Canada versus Sweden, and Germany would go on to the final.
You know, at this point on the field, these U.S. players have got to be telling themselves, I'm going to make a difference. And every single one of them has got to win, go after every ball and try and win every second ball.
Germany has played great in this World Cup thus far, but the USA still came in as a favorite. But everyone knew that Germany could, on their day, beat the United States. But it's still an upset.
You're right, JP. These are the two best teams in the World Cup in 2003.
Prinz, open player. Meinert's going to walk into the box. And Meinert will end it. Marlon Meinert with a goal. Germany celebrates. The danger that you two talked about, coming back at the counterattacks, it finally paid off for Germany.
Well, you know, they're just so good at knowing what pass to make. Prinz knew she had that pass, and then Meinert gets in that situation. That's why she was MVP of the WUSA. She's not going to miss that opportunity.
A two-goal lead now for Germany in the second minute of stoppage time. Now you're talking miracles for a USA comeback.
You know, in a one-goal game is a different story. There's still a lot of time left on the clock. But a two-goal game, that is almost impossible for this U.S. squad to come back and get two goals in order to send it into overtime.
Wendy, I just have to believe that Shannon's knee probably isn't well enough for her to be in this game because I think there could have been a sub or two but a defensive personality for an attacking personality. Pierce is a little bit more of an attacking personality than Sobrero and, of course, McMillan.
Germany with the ball. They'll be celebrating in that nation tonight. I'm sure this game is being televised in Germany as the flag goes up on Prinz.
Again, I thought the closer the game, the edge would go to the USA because they fought tougher games to go all the way. Germany wasn't tested, but today they showed their mettle and their pride. Here's Ham. USA looking for one quick one. It's rolling toward goal. It's blocked. Still loose. And if they can't score there, you wonder if they could score at all.
You know, and a lot of times you have to have a little luck go your way. And what I've seen every time the U.S. has gone into this box when there's 50-50 balls and they're not finishing them is the Germany player is the one who's there with the ball out of foot.
Look at that pass from Leiter to Prinz. Taking Scurry out. Germany gets their third goal. Prinz. Germany are going to the World Cup final. And the USA will not.
Well, Germany's put an explanation point on this game. They know how to counterattack. They're getting the opportunities. Look at this great run by Minert. She drags the defense across. Then she finds Birgit Prinz. Birgit is not going to panic here. She touches a ball wide of Brianna Scurry. And she finds the back of the net.
Denon Kola to the watch. Shot is over. Game over. Germany is going to the final. And the USA are eliminated from the World Cup. They'll play for the third place match. Faces we haven't seen in a long time. The USA have lost this one, and you can see how much it hurts them. But for Germany, they'll celebrate and go to the finals again like they did in 1995 when they lost to Norway. Germany have shocked the United States. It's a 3-0 final. They will go on and play in the World Cup final, and we'll come back with some interviews, so stay with us. ABC and ESPN, official broadcast partners for the FIFA World Cup and Major League Soccer.
Look, it's the guy who falls.
Fall now.
Oh, I don't really do that anymore. It's not like I got that insurance.
What insurance?
Aflac.
They pay you cash if you can't work when you get hurt. Not that I ever do. Aisle 5 under lingerie.
Price check.
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Aflac.
TI. Get into it.
Swim class, $60. Hockey camp, $340. Driving lessons, $250. Being able to let go. Being able to let go. Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For parents everywhere, there's MasterCard.
Best bowlers in the world, bending the laws of physics. The PBA Tour is back. Spin Doctors Chris Barnes and Norm Duke lead the pack into the first tourney of the season. The PBA Banquet Open, Sunday, October 12th at 1 on ESPN.
Rock and roll legend Roger Daltrey.
On the History Channel?
I never knew history could be this hard.
The History Channel presents Extreme History, hosted by Roger Daltrey.
Come along with Roger as he relives some of history's epic adventures under the most primitive conditions.
Have you ever eaten beaver?
Extreme History, hosted by Roger Daltrey.
Watch the bloody show.
Premieres tonight at 9:30. Only on the History Channel.
Where the friggin' past comes alive.
In Roger's case, a little too alive.
Hello, Lawrence Marshall. Before you pay too much at some big city dealer, call 1-866-CLOBBER and get your low Marshall discount price right over the phone. Lawrence Marshall Chevrolet in Hempstead, we clobber big city prices.
Radio Shack presents Last Night in Major League Soccer. MLS Soccer Saturday, presented by Radio Shack.
Welcome back, everyone. This is not the way most people expected it to end. And, Wendy, tears in the eyes of several players. This is supposed to be a final World Cup for many like Mia Hamm. And surely they thought they were going to get to the final.
Well, you just can't imagine what's going through their minds right now. They just wish they'd had this game back and done some things a little better. They had great chances early on in the match, and they didn't convert them. And then, you know, coming back from being one down, one goal down, is just a tough hurdle. Things just didn't go their way today. They didn't have any luck.
More, Tony, like a 1-0 game than 3-0. The score may be misleading when people tune in. Two goals in the end against the run of play when USA was striking that goal, but it's still a bad loss.
Right on, JP. I mean, it's a 1-0 loss, but when you're pushing forward and you're playing against a team that knows how to counterattack, that knows how to break out, they're going to have an opportunity to score goals. We saw them coming, and they stuck to at the end.
USA had more chances today than Germany, but they couldn't connect.
Like we said early on, they really did have their chances. One of the biggest things that came up against, though, is the wonderful play of Rotenberg in the goal box, sending a goal over. Milbert really did a good job when she came in, provided a great spark, got in behind the defense a number of times, but the U.S. just wasn't able to convert.
Some disappointment on the young players as well, because they probably feel deep down, Tony, that they're letting down some of the veterans if this is their last World Cup.
Well, I'm sure there is, but this is one team, and that's one of the trademarks of the U.S. is that they win and they lose together. It's one team. But, you know, Germany did what they needed to do. They needed to match the USA mentality, and they did. And they needed a great game from Rotenberg, and she delivered. And you got to give them full credit. These were the two best teams I thought I saw in the World Cup. And we saw them both in the semifinal.
As good as Nordby was in the Norway game, Rotenberg took it up another step. And I don't know if you guys saw what I was seeing. We're all looking at different things. But Brandi Chastain, when the game was over, trying to encourage some of the other players. She was a cheerleader right at the very end. Germany wins this one 3-0. Here's how they do it.
So the first goal for Germany was key. That's a great head ball by Gerhard Frenkes. Here's the second one. Prince laying it off the Meinhardt breakaway, back of the net. And then Meinhardt laying it off the Prince around Scurry, back of the net.
And in the end, Brianna Scurry is all by herself with the rest of the team looking for a goal to get him back into the game. And it ends up 3-0. We have Tisha Hogue down on the field with April Heinrich, so let's go downstairs. Tisha.
Coach, I know this is difficult. What was the difference today in the match?
You know, the margin is so slim in this game. And I thought we had our chances. We had some great service. We had end line. We brought our A game in terms of the attacking today. We had our chances. Their goalkeeper played great. That's a great team we played. And I got to think that maybe is the greatest game ever played in women's soccer right there. Attacking, hanging it out over the edge, trying to get a goal, and making women's soccer and helping sell women's soccer.
What will you tell the kids in the locker room?
I love them. I wouldn't take any other team.
Coach, we're all proud of you. This crowd is still chanting USA, and you have a lot to be proud of. Good luck in the next game.
Thank you, Tish. Tony, you were in the locker room in 95, so you know what it is like when you're on the losing end.
Well,